Were individually saved from something, then maybe all of us were corporately saved from something larger. Can we really be sure what's left? What state is Earth in right now? When is Earth right now?
You can just keep connecting all the trees, all the roots. I gotta finish the plates around the tree and get them connected to my battery.
Tomorrow I will talk with CW. He could be swayed from his battery plan. What gives one species the right to destroy another species? Who gets to choose? Do I just lay down and die because the more aggressive species thinks they're better, more powerful? I will not be trampled. I will kick and scream and survive. May God have mercy on my soul. Alright, well, let's start exploring. Okay. Does this just take me around back to this rock again? Like where we came in? Oh, it does definitely look like it does that. Yep, okay. This where, oh yeah. No sense swapping back though. Ooh, this looks desolate. Now, this sphere, of course, is paired with the Hunrath sphere, which of course comes from Earth, most specifically Arizona. So just like the scenery, oh, there's the tree already. The scenery that we see outside the Hunrath sphere is Mofang. This outside this sphere should be Arizona on Earth. Got a lot of fog coming up here. So that is like our sun right there. Wow, it's a tree already. This just looks empty. Not running into any kind of puzzles or obstacles. That path that way. The tree was this way. Are we just gonna get straight to the tree? It sure looks like it. Well, okay. Well, that will be. That's our easiest trip to the tree ever. Explore around a little bit more first. You know, I've been thinking about sort of the sequence of events that got this whole story to this point right here. And I'm really thinking, actually, and this is largely based upon the book that is in Farley's bedroom, that it is the villains and the humans that actually precipitated this little battle. Well, at least finished it, let's put it that way. Definitely Farley's describing their actions as being aggressive. So much so that she felt uncomfortable with it, but at the same time she felt that it was necessary. Also, the sign-in book that is in Murray. And again, I noticed this only upon editing the video from the last video. Shavar was a Mofang. There are a couple of Mofang that are also chambered there. So what I'm thinking is Shavar and this other Mofang, they are the ones that... They are the ones that perhaps came to Hunrath explaining that the Mofang were planning to attack them. And then the people of Hunrath and the villains and the Arya and the patriarchs decided that they were going to concoct a plan to get the Mofang first. And so what we had is everybody getting chambered, the vast majority of people getting chambered in Moray. The Arya finding that, whoa. This is Earth. That does not look good. And I'm pretty sure CW's plan is to get us back here. Return this whole... Swap the spheres again. Swap the whole big spheres. So that Hunrath ends up back in Arizona. Might want to think about that. Anyway. Getting back to it. So they came up with this plan. This is my theory anyway, but I think it fits. They came up with this plan to attack Mofang first. And I think those destructive devices, though certainly a Mofang origin, the bomb that we disabled in Moray, I think there were three of them. And I think it was the villains and the humans and the Arya that swapped those bombs to Mofang, wiping them out first. And so they had this plan that the remainers would swap the bombs in, then swap back, leaving the bombs behind to destroy the swapping devices so that the Mofang can't get them and then destroy the Mofang first. That's my theory. And the Hunrath swapping location was actually seemed to be in pretty good shape. So my guess is that they're trying to do them all at the same time, but you can't time things perfectly. CW swapped first, and that went perfectly fine. That, of course, alerted the remaining Mofang that would have survived that first blast. I think they then went to Kaptar, because there is signs of a battle that occurred at the swapping location of the remainder there. Though I guess they got it off, and that remainder was able to successfully complete their mission and get their destructive device to Mofang. But then the remaining Mofang attacked Moray. And that's that battle that we saw right towards the conclusion of our journey through Moray. And the villains weren't able to get rid of their device, and we saw it there. If you read the sort of document from Farley that is at each of the remaining stations, it talks about you have to swap and swap back quickly, or else you may end up detonating the device in your own sphere. Anyway, that's it. We have now watered that tree. That was pretty easy, so let's get ourselves back to Hunrath. I think it's just following this pipe. Yep. And we'll see what CW has to say. Okay, CW, we've got to be moving into the end game now. Okay, so there's a document in the mayor's office. Actually, we got to go through there anyway, so why don't we take a look at it? Here we are. This one. believe, talks about the bleeder and how the bleeder is designed because they were concerned about what would happen if the mother seeds, which are the trees, get to full fruition. So they designed a bleeder to drain energy from the walls. And CW's plan, and this over here is the bleeder this way. There's the bleeder. So we gotta somehow destroy that. CW's plan is to swap these big spheres. Actually, that gets me a thing. I don't think CW's plan's a good one, because he swaps these big spheres, gets us to go back home to Earth. Earth doesn't look healthy to me. So I think I might just sabotage his plan, because his battery right there is an essential component to being able to perform the swap. So what we're just gonna do is disconnect it. He has been harping at us to make sure we connect the battery. Here we are. Sorry, CW. But they don't give me the option to actually talk to you about this. So I think this is going to be our best option. Now, here's a question. How do we get ourselves to the bleeder? There's definitely a path over there on the other side. Oh, and we got beetles around the bleeder, too. How to get over there? Yeah, and it seems like you guys want me to come over this way. I can see you. There's beetles all around here. I need to get over there. But this is what's got me thinking about Farley's here. This map. Here's the bleeder. And you can see that there's a section of wall we can swap through. This is the section of wall up above the waterfall. Is there a way to get there? I don't think this is working. No. No, that waterfall needs to be working. In order for that to work, there's nothing from CW's battery going that way or anything. No, okay. Going on here. Oh no, I still can't get across that. Even if I did, what would it serve? Okay, just hang on. Could connecting the battery somehow make that elevator work? No, hang on. Okay. Forget it. Oh my goodness gracious. Yes, I see what's happened here. Okay. Disconnect that again. Alright, so CW has moved his little train. He's got his little train over here. He has it over there to be doing his work around the tree. That has opened up this path. In fact, I have access to a door here. Oh my gosh, okay. I don't need that elevator. Nope. I do not. Okay. We have access to the bleeder now. So we can go through. You know what? Let's turn on this waterfall. We're turning off the waterfall, really, right? Because that will make... Oh, it won't let me do that. Okay. Just thinking that will function that elevator again, but I guess I don't need that elevator anymore. Okay, we are going through the wall here. Okay, we're closing in on things now, I think. Alright. What's this way? Does this go anywhere? No. No. Nope, 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 nope. I'm stuck. There we go. Alright, we are at the bleeder. CW wants us to destroy this. Another panel. Oh, he isn't effing around. Okay. Now, let's hook this up. That connects. Oh, here we go. That's connecting this red wire here, and that red wire, I remember it now, it goes all the way up to that. Yes, there's a detonator up there on the tower, so let's get up to the tower. Okay, we have power. You can see that we got power to all the trees here. I think CW has all the power he needs except for, well, I sabotaged him, didn't I? Okay, here is our detonator that red wire goes to. Ooh. I hurt some stuff there. Ouch. Okay, now what? Oh!
Almost there. Real good. Not much left. Just wait for all the natural way of things to happen now. Lots of folks left behind. But I reckon they've passed. I don't move real well. Carson legs. You can see how it
I love your little train. Oh, that's my train.
Unplugging my battery. We're going home, not wherever.
All right then, I'll power up my override. When the time comes, it works a lot like the little swappers. It'll swap us home. Spend much time here, and that ain't a bad thing. But there were some fine folk. Some real fine folk. I reckon you got the best seat in the house up there.
Go. Don't look so bad.
What in blazes? Wait, I'll be.
Cecil.
Caroline.
This is so incredible.
Dear Lord, you made it. How many others?
We all made it. I'm heading your way. Stay where you are.
That's it. But of course, you know, that's not the only way in which we had to end. So why don't we take a look at what would have happened if I had kept that battery cable plugged in. Yeah, this don't look good. Here, some chicken. So that concludes Obduction. I hope that you enjoyed this series. I do have one episode left. In case you are interested, I want to take a much more closer look at the villain number system. Otherwise, we are at the end of the series. I thank you for making it this far and hope to see you again in some of my other series.